When we first moved into the van, some of our friends gave us really great advice. They lived on the road for 3 years, and they told us that it takes about 6 months before you really get to know what life on the road is going to be like for you. And now that we've been on the road for 7 months, we definitely see what they meant. And we're realizing that we need to make some changes.
To be completely honest with you guys, the way we've been doing it hasn't worked for us. And I'll be honest, if we continue living the way that we're living, I'm not sure we can handle it much longer. So here's our new routine. Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday are going to be work days. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday are going to be fun and leisure days where we plan all of the adventures, we have downtime, and we try to separate as much as we can work from play. Today's Saturday, so let's go for a hike. The first thing we know we need to do is get out of the van more. So we're planning a lot of hikes, a lot of things to do, and we're in Canyonlands National Park. We're going to go hit a trail.
We just started this trail. We're about half a mile in, and we went in a complete wrong direction to start, but we're with our friends Kaylee and Logan. We met up with them before, back in Vegas and back in Phoenix, and now we're hanging out with them again. So they're finally making it to the vlog. They didn't make it the other two times. Sorry, guys.
This trail's actually pretty hard. The knees are kind of hurting, but how cool is it that we're hiking into a canyon and then back out? It's almost like we've never done that before.
You got it in you, I know you do.
But we have.
We just made it to the bottom of the canyon. It's not as grand as the Grand Canyon, but the views are absolutely dope. It was very steep, and I'm sure there's a mountain lion somewhere out here stalking us, because now Kaylee and Logan were telling us about mountain lions, and I'm terrified. Drop a comment below if you are also terrified of mountain lions. Be safe out there, guys and girls.
Now we go up.
Everybody give a thumbs up for proper hydration.
Woo-hoo!
Woo!
All right, morale check. We're at the base of hell. So, we're all tired, but this is the fun part, where you go straight uphill, and no more downhill.
I feel like that was very hard, and I feel like I need to watch some YouTube videos about how to breathe in elevation.
Do you think you would do this hike again?
I don't need to do this hike again.
We saw what we saw.
Yeah.
Yep. I believe they call this a take it or leave it hike, and in this case, sit damp of appeal, leave it. We're designating 3 days a week to solid working. So Sunday is kind of like our cleaning and preparing day.
We realized that our temperament is very closely related to how clean it is in this van on a regular basis. And I wouldn't say Matt and I are messy, but we're not the tidiest of people, and neither of us are neat freaks. So it can get really unruly in here. So what we're gonna try to do is deep clean every Sunday. And that's what I'm doing right now, which is perfect because
what we've been doing is like, oh, we need to do laundry, let's go do laundry. Oh, we need water, let's just go find water. Oh, we need groceries, let's go get groceries. It's been very disorganized, so we'll find ourselves leaving a cool campsite to go into town for one thing, and then we go back, and then we realize, oh, we need to do something else, and all of a sudden we have no clean underwear, and we're like, oh my god. So what we're gonna do is, between these 3 days, is all of the chores, everything that requires being in town, and the rest of the other 4 days of the week are completely free for whatever adventures or exploring we wanna do. It's time to make some changes to make this life a little bit more, I'd say, sustainable for us, because we're able to get by, but we could make it better.
I think if we do this every single week, we'll be good for the week and not, you know, hate it.
Good morning. We've decided that we need to get a ton of work done today, so today we're going to take you on a day in the life of a chore and work day with us. We're going to go into town, we're going to get some work done. We were going to stay at this cool camp spot, but we realized that it'd probably be better for focus and attention to go back to the Moab library. Super convenient there. They have good Wi-Fi. It's very clean. There's water. There's flushable toilets, and we are out of toilet paper, so we need to get some of that today.
I don't know if we've made this clear yet, but we're making a conscious decision to go to a place to get work done, because this is the place where we sleep, we eat, we go to the bathroom, and it's all within 70 square feet. So it's nice to just get out of the van, use some public toilets, and really just get work done, hammer it down, and then we can reassociate our van with play, travel, and fun.
All right, it's laundry time, and on laundry day, we've usually been wearing the same clothes for a few days, so it's finally time to get out of this shirt. I'm sure you guys have seen me in a lot of this shirt and wondering, Matt, how many gray shirts do you have? The answer is, this is my only one light gray shirt. I have several other shades of gray shirts. Look at me, I'm wearing something other than that gray shirt. This is now my other slightly gray shirt.
It's black.
It may look black, but I promise you, it's actually basalt. Not bath salts. Basalt.
Basalt.
Basalt. That's what the tag says.
Bye right, bye, so, baby.
All right. I'm off to go do man's work. The laundromat. Where the
you
men go.
You are the biggest, strongest man.
Yeah, biggest, strong man.
Give me a big old kiss. Not the camera.
While Matt's in the laundromat, I want to quickly explain how we make money now. It's been a little while since I quit my job, and we haven't really updated you guys on what we do for work now. So we are full-time content creators. We partner with brands to create short-form content for them. We also make money by getting sponsored on our channels, but most of our work is for clients and partners. Voiceovers are a little hard to do, especially if you don't have a script. I have a script in front of me, but every time I do a voiceover, I go off script somehow. Oh, I guess we'll find out. All right, I think I got it. It took me a few tries, but I think I got it.
All right, I am back from the laundromat. My clothes are now clean and sparkly, very hot and very dry. I added an extra 4 minutes to the dryer to make sure that everything's dry because Megan often complains that, Matt, they're still kind of damp. Also, watch me fold this laundry and see how bad of a job I do compared to Megan, because I guarantee she's going to say something about it when she takes her headphones off. Too short because I desperately need a drink. Babe, I'm folding this hot ass laundry, which is your job.
Babe, we're a team. We're not against each other. You can have some bubbly.
Yeah, we can share our bubbly like we share everything in our lives. The camera's rolling. Relationship goals, am I right? So, Megan just finished editing the YouTube video, and I finished doing our laundry. Well, really, Megan finished folding it, because that's kind of the thing that she likes to do the most. So, I would never want to take that away from her. But, we're off to McDonald's, aka Macca's, to upload the video.
We spent a lot of time in Macca's parking lots and Walmart parking lots just using their Wi-Fi, and this is how we get our videos up very quickly.
Alright, we just got into a little bit of a tiffle because somebody here has a little bit of an attitude.
I've just been working all morning.
So have I.
This is why we're doing this, guys.
You could have gone into Macca's.
I would have had to pay for something.
You could have bought me some ice cream.
Bought you with some ice cream?
Bought me some ice cream. I bought you some ice cream yesterday. Living in 70 square feet with your partner definitely has lots of challenges on its own. And then couple in running a business together and doing everything together. You can see how it gets a little old. Let's go to the library. Vamos a biblioteca.
All right, we got a lot of work done, but I am exhausted. I feel like I worked all day. And up until we did this whole 3 days of work thing, I feel like I've been working at this rate every single day. So this is gonna be great because the next 4 days after Tuesday is gonna be very relaxing and very much healing after all of this work. I think it's gonna be worth it.
It'll be adventure time.
Yeah.
No, you're tired. All right, so Megan's really tired.
I said I was tired.
Megan's tired. Megan's in a bad mood.
Tired.
Megan's transformed from being really tired to just in a straight up bad mood.
The CEO is out.
It's like they say, you leave a 9-to-5 to go work a 24/7. And that's what we're at right now. We're kind of at a 24/7 hustle grind mode. But we are working on creating balance to the showers.
It's been like 5 days, guys. Do we have the tickets?
We got the tickets.
Yay! And I'm so tired, guys. I'm
oh,
so tired.
Megan. You know what you need?
A good shower?
Good old f***ing. We can't put that on video, can we?
I'm gonna bleep that out. You guys comment below what you think he said. To save time, we're gonna divide and conquer. I am gonna go get the groceries, and Matt's gonna go get water, and possibly get us some peat moss for the nature's head because it's past its prime.
Bye. Oh, come on. All right, my job's to get the water. Yep, that happens. And now I just wait. Usually only takes about 6 minutes when it's full, and it's about half full, but we're just topping it off, so I should only take a few. But if I were to do this again, I'd probably put in some kind of remote fill back here or on the outside wall so I could fill it and not have to open up the back doors and take stuff out and all that.
So I just emptied all the water out of that. It's a little hose dance I made up. It's pretty awesome. Try that party sometimes. Definitely gets you laid. Now to the next stop.
She's making some curry tonight. I hope. I've been begging for curry for like 3-4 days. And yes, I could make it myself, but Megan does such a better job at it. And I know it brings her joy, making me happy. That's what she's here for, right? Just kidding. A joke. A joke. We're turning around and she does this thing where she calls me and then she's like, I'm here. And then I'm like, where are you? And she's like, I'm here and I don't see you. And then she yells at me and it's very frustrating. Put the little flashers on, don't run over Megan. I don't know what she thinks she was doing. Ugh! Hi there.
Hello, darling. We got a lot of food.
Nice.
Because up until now we've been going to the grocery store twice a week. I'm hoping that bringing it down to once a week, we can save a little bit of money and, you know, not have to run to the store every 4 days. It's been a long day.
All right, one of us has so much energy and the other has none. Who could it be? Anyways, we're back at camp now. Megan is in charge of making the delicious curry that I was telling you about earlier when I was getting our poo-poo peat moss.
I'm too tired.
All right, well, why don't you get to making food?
You make it.
No, Megan, you owe me curry.
I feel like I'm overworked and I'm a housewife. An overworked housewife.
Ugh. Curry is served. Yum, smells delicious.
I hope you love it.
I'm sure I will.
Oh, I'm so tired.
It's time to eat some food. I think we're gonna call it for the night, and then tomorrow...
Back to work.
So, see you in the morning. Morning, it's Tuesday. We may have gone a little bit too hard with our work on Monday and Sunday, because it's 10:30 and we're just waking up. But it was nice to sleep in, have some Megan mat time.
Yeah. I think yesterday we just packed too much into one day, and the next week around we'll just spread out the work within. But I don't think we have too much to do today because we went so hard yesterday.
I have so much to do today. Speak for yourself.
What a fail of a day. We have not left our spot. We were supposed to go to the library, but we just didn't. And we had a meeting here, and now we're starting work here. I'd really like to go to the library.
At this rate...
It's already 2:30, but we've been working in the van all day.
So let's open the door. The sun's out.
Yay!
And look, the cows are getting closer.
They are! So we've been mostly working in the van. We haven't done a great job of leaving the campsite. As long as we are working and not fighting, we're fine. And it's almost 5:00, so workday is nearly over.
So now we get to explore and enjoy the next 4 days. We got some really exciting things that we're going to be trying. Megan finished an entire season of Bridgerton in one day.
I did.
What time were you up till last night?
I don't know. I didn't look. This is why I can't watch TV shows, because I have to know what happens next. I have to. And then I don't sleep for a whole day. But good thing today is a leisure day, so I can just leisure.
All right, YouTube fam. We have a problem here. Middle of the day, adventure day, we're supposed to go do fun stuff, and Megan's decided to stay up all night till probably 4 or 5 in the morning watching Netflix. Not how I want to start this new routine.
Alright, Matt's gone mad. He made up a game. Throw that rock?
Yeah, rock toss.
Rock toss?
Yeah, you might want to find a smaller rock, unless you want to throw the same rock as me.
You want to show me?
Yeah, so my technique.
How manly and burly you are?
My technique's different, so we're gonna mark yours with a little stick.
I did not expect that.
So far, our first day off of rest day has consisted of me throwing a rock, me doing some workouts, Megan sleeping, Megan making steak sandwiches. Although Megan has cooked for me all day, so I'm not really going to complain about her staying up all night if that means I get to eat all day.
What up?
Oh my gosh! Unfortunately, we've been working, and it's gonna take a little while for us to like drop work completely. Also because we have like something really exciting planned for the end of the month. So after this big thing at the end of April, hopefully we can pull back and autopilot a little bit better.
We're really excited for what we're gonna be doing at the end of the month. It's a major, major project. If you can guess, comment down below. Make sure to go check out our other videos. Remember to like this video, subscribe to our channel if you haven't already, and we'll see you in the next one.